Hi all, today I am going to explain you about transport level security. In this, our first topic is web security consideration. So nowadays everyone is using internet throughout the world, like business, government agencies and many other individuals like us. When the users are increasing, the attackers also increase in the same way. So to overcome the threats, means complex software hides many software circuits. To overcome the threats, we are using an antivirus in our system. So if we use an antivirus, we can easily configure and manage. Users are not known about the risk. Means antivirus, with the help of antivirus, we can overcome the complex problems. And there are majorly two types of attacks. One is the active attack and the other one is passive attack. In passive attack, when A is sending a message to B, means A transfers a message hi to B. In the meanwhile, the hacker will attack the message and he will see what A is sending to B. Means in the passive attack, the hacker can see the message, whatever the conversation is going on between the two persons. In the active attack, A and B, there are two persons. A is sending a message to B. The hacker can not only see the message but also modify the message. In the passive attack, the hacker can modify the message. So after completion of the web security consideration, let us have a look on web traffic security approaches. There are various approaches which are used for providing security to the web. Example is Internet Protocol Security. So these are the list of components of threats on web. There are majorly four parameters: integrity, confidentiality, authentication, and then denial of service. In this, the first parameter is integrity. Integrity means we will modify our user data. So here we can see an example of integrity. Here there are two persons, Andy and Sam. So they both want to converse each other by using a mail. So here Andy is sending a message, "Hey Sam, how are you?" And here Sam is receiving a message like, "Hey Sam, lend me $100 please." So what happened? In the meanwhile, the hacker attacked the message and he modified the message. So this is called active attack, where the hacker is active, means he not only see the message but he can modify the message. So that is called active attack. So here the threats occur in the integrity are modification of user data, Trojan horse browser, means unwanted browsers, and modification of memory, means when the client is having 100 GB in his system, he can rob the GB and he can change the GB into 20 GB. And the next one is modification of message, traffic in transfer. So these are the threats in integrity, and the effects of these threats are loss of information. So whatever Andy is sending the message, he lost his information. And then auto accepting machine means sometimes in the internet we'll get a unwanted site without our permission. Directly the system will accept is yes or no. The system directly accepts yes and will browse that site. So with that unwanted websites, our system get damaged and our files also will get damaged. The prevention measures to overcome the threats are cryptography techniques like AES algorithm, DES algorithm, and RSA, Diffie-Hellman. So this type of algorithms we can use to prevent the threats. And the next one is confidentiality. Confidentiality is nothing but to provide a password to the message. Example, we are using our mobiles. As we are using our mobile is having a password. In the same way, our friend is also having the password. Our friend is also having the password. When we want to send a message from WhatsApp, we will open our mobile with the help of password and we will send a message hi. So the third person cannot see our password. And when our friend is friend want to see our message, he will use his mobile password and he will see that message and he can see the message what we are sending. So here we can explain it with a clear example. Here there are two friends, Bob and Alice. Bob want to send a message hello to Alice. So to encrypt the message, he is using a password, public key. So with the help of this public key, he will encrypt this message. And with the help of decryption, by using a private key, he will decrypt the message and he will receive the message what Bob has sent it. That is nothing but hello. So finally, Bob sent hello to Alice. Means in this, the hacker cannot see the message. If he see the message also, he cannot identify because this is a scrambled sentence which is not understandable to others. The threats caused in the confidentiality are eavesdropping on the net. This is a type of hacker and he will steal the information from the server and client. Information about the client server communication also he can see, knowing network configuration. So these are all the types of threats which occur in confidentiality. So effects of this confidentiality is, when confidentiality is not there, we lose the information and we lose our privacy. So to overcome these problems, we have a prevention method like encryption and decryption. And the next parameter is authentication. Authentication means to check whether the person is receiving the message correctly or not. Means the sender and the receiver are authenticated or not, we have to check. So here the threats occur are attackers introducing as users. Means when hello is sent by the sender, here attacker, he attacks the message and he will see, he will show him as like a user. And then data forgery, the attacker will modify the data. The effects for these threats are getting fake information, believe that false information is valid. When we get the message, we will believe that the information is coming from the right person. So to overcome that threats, we have a prevention measures in cryptography techniques like RSA, Diffie-Hellman, Blowfish and some of the algorithms which can be used to prevent these threats. And the last parameter is denial of service. Denial of service means when we are sending a message, the message will not be received from the sender to the receiver. So message will be denied. So the threats coming from this are killing of the user threads, flood machine with unwanted request memory from you, DNS attacks to the system. DNS means domain name server. Domain name server attacks to the system. The effects which will come from these threats are interruption. When we are sending a message, we will get interrupted. And sometimes we are getting unwanted messages continuously. Because of that, we will get irritation and our work will be automatically stopped because of that continuous messages. The prevention measures to overcome these threats are, it is difficult to prevent but by using firewall, we can overcome some little bit this problem. By using firewall. And the location of the security in TCP/IP protocol are, first one is network layer. In this network layer, internet protocol provides security to the network layer. And the next one is transportation layer. In this transportation layer, SSL provides security to transportation layer. SSL means secure socket layer. So here SSL provides security to transportation layer. And in the third one, application layer, this application layer, SMIME, PGP set, these three provide security to application layer. SMIME means security multipurpose internet mail extension, and PGP means pretty good privacy. And the third one, set, means secure extension transfer. So in this application layer, security, multipurpose internet mail extension, pretty good privacy, and secure extension transfer, these three provide security to application layer. In the transport layer, secure socket layer provides security to transport layer. In internet protocol, network layer provides security to that. Thank you.